Hey, how's it going? Quick video for a Sunday. Got a few Blu-rays and 4Ks to run through what I've been watching lately. So I've been doing a bit of streaming as well. I watched a new one on Shudder the other night called Hellhole. I'll cover that in my overall monthly watch video, which I do sort of where I screen record letterboxed and go over everything. I'll do that sort of like next weekend perhaps, or end of this week. But this is all the stuff I've watched lately on physical media, you know, Blu-ray, 4Ks. Picked up a bunch of stuff in the Severance sale, and I picked up this one, Midnight. Apparently it's a video nasty as well, not sure what section or anything like that, but apparently it was. And yeah, this is Midnight from 1980. English language, 94 minutes, basically a sort of backwards slasher slash satanic panic movie. I thought it was pretty good. I didn't like love the film or anything, but it was okay. Like, you know, it had some like good moments. You know, you got the homicidal rednecks, graphic butchery, as it says here, and devil worship. So I was just reading the back of the Blu-ray there, but I thought it was okay. I've seen a lot of films sort of like it, you know, there's kind of like backwards slashers, you know, with weird characters and antagonists and things like that. But yeah, it was pretty good little ride, like, to go on, you know, like a bit of carnage, you know, some violence and stuff. Not too bad, Midnight. There's a look at the back. Didn't blow me away though, but I didn't, these films don't, you know. A lot of these films are like very obscure and quite a required taste. But yeah, I thought Midnight was okay. I gave it like a, I think I gave it a 2.5 out of 5, so sort of halfway mark. Did a video on this one, Funeral Home, recently watched. Fantastic transfer. Film's good stuff, you know, tells a mysterious story. It's also a slasher, and it's only certificate 12, and it's quite a violent one, to be fair. You know, there's a little bit of color in there with the blood, and yeah, quite an interesting little story. But video for that one on the channel where I go into a bit more detail. That's Funeral Home from 88 Films. Last Sunday was Texas Chainsaw Massacre Day, which I forgot about, but I did catch up on the Monday and watch one of my all-time favorites, the original TCM. Watch this 4K in this set. Really good 4K from last year that was put out. The film's never looked better. It's going to be hard to actually make the film look better because it's also kept its you know, natural look intact. It's I know a lot of people complain about these transfers, for example, say like with Aliens, where it's been smoothed over, and you know, they've used like CGI to really gloss the film up and make it look like it was shot in today. And I think Aliens look good as a transfer, but this sort of transfer, it keeps its natural look. So it's a very good transfer. It's got a lot of detail, nice and colourful, as a lot of the scenes are set in the Texas afternoon sun in the daylight. But it also keeps, it's got a bit of grain and stuff to it. So this is a very natural looking transfer, and that's probably the best way to go, really, if you want to keep everyone happy. But yeah, second time I watched the 4K, I've seen the film numerous times as I love it. Yeah, great film, watching Leatherface, you know, and his clan of cannibal family members terrorize the, you know, Sally and her and Franklin and all their friends. Yeah, very good stuff. I actually forgot about the great scene. I did an appreciation video, and I forgot to mention the great scene where which character is it? Is it I forget the male character's name, but he goes in, and it's, I think it's, oh, damn it, I forgot his name, but the guy with the sort of little afro, he goes into Leatherface's kitchen at the back of the house, and he opens the chest freezer, and Pam's dead corpse kind of has like an post-death reaction and kind of comes up. Whoa, you'll know what scene I mean, where Pam bursts out the freezer. She's already dead, but she kind of has like a, it's kind of like an after-death, post-death reflex. But yeah, fantastic watching Texas Chainsaw Massacre again. Never get tired of this film. Always watch it once a year around the summertime. Yeah, really enjoyed that one. Probably ramble on about Texas Chainsaw Massacre all day. Did mention this on my haul video, but I watched Tales from the Dark Side, the 4K upgrade. Yeah, looks good. Good anthology film. Love the gargoyle segment. You got Steve Buscemi in one of the segments. Debbie Harry's in the wraparound. Who else is in this film? Christian Slater's in it. I forgot about him. He's in it. Really enjoyed it though. Looked great in 4K. It's a worthwhile upgrade. The Blu-ray was good, but this looked a lot better. Nice sharp picture, and yeah, it's just great watching all the stories again. And the third segment, the Gargoyle one's just really good, and it's just got, you know, amazing special effects, and it grabs you. Yeah, enjoyable that one. Don't have too much to say about Tales from Dark Side the movie, but I have a little bit to say about this one. Another Severin pickup, The Sinful Dwarf. Now, this was sleazy and grimy, and it's that type of film that makes you feel a little bit dirty. I'll go over the narrative a little bit. It's about this dwarf who, like, lives in an apartment building where a lot of the apartments are there to be rented out. You've got your landlord, who's basically in charge of the dwarf. And yeah, the dwarf is just a menace, basically. The landlord knows what she's doing, but she has young women that they've kidnapped in a secret chamber in one of the rooms beyond an caged door, and they're basically taken against their will, held up in this room, pimped out as prostitutes for the boarding house's guests or whoever decides to come and pay a fee to the landlady. And basically these young women are there held captive. They're naked with no clothes on. They're kept like sort of animals, and they're been hooked on heroin. So suppose, you know, if you want to do some sort of like dodgy nefarious things, you could hook somebody on heroin and get them to comply to anything. And that's what the dwarf and this woman have done. They've hooked these women on heroin. So they're just waiting on their next fix, and these guys come and, you know, have sex with them, pay for it. Like, they're basically being used as prostitutes, pimped out. The dwarf's cruel to them. He goes in, he's very you know, he's very sleazy and very leering, you know, he leers at the women and stuff. This young couple move in. You've got the guy who's I think he's a writer and he's trying to get a book published. And you've got his girlfriend who is left in the apartment while he goes out for the day and about his business. She's left in the apartment. The dwarf's keeping his eye on her. And subsequently, won't spoil too much, but she gets put into the cage. And the boyfriend's wondering where she's gone. The dwarf wants to, and the landlady want to, because she's been snooping around. This young woman's been snooping around as well and having a look and found this area in the house where the women are kept. Then the dwarf and the landlady decide to do it to her. They hold her up in the cage. The husband's looking for her. I watched the triple X version, so there's a, you know, there's a nastier cut with more like dirty scenes in and stuff, you know, showing you like direct penetration and stuff like that, which I don't think's in the regular cut. But the triple X version, you see like direct penetration. There's a scene where the dwarf basically puts his stick, you can see he's got like a cane there, and he basically puts it up somebody. So bit some sort of gnarly stuff in there, some icky stuff. Yeah, it's a very sleazy film. I do recommend it if you like your sort of sleazy grindhouse movies. Well worth a watch. I didn't think it was that good. I thought some of it was quite boring as well, just the sort of meandering scenes, but there was some graphic stuff in there and some nasty things as well, and it's a bit of a dirty one. As I said, I did watch the triple X rated version, so you're getting plenty of you know, it's plenty of sexually orientated scenes and that. Yeah, nothing too disturbing or anything. It's just a bit of a dirty movie. That's the Sinful Dwarf. So quite a fun watch, like interesting film. And the dwarf, the actor who plays the dwarf is pretty damn good. And he is called, it says here, pint-sized pervert Torben Bill or Billy. So yeah, Sinful Dwarf. If you're into your grindhouse sleazy movies, give it a go. 70s, typical 70s stuff, 70s grindhouse, you know, got that aesthetic and everything. It's from the 70s. I think it's 1970, 74. Anyway, I wanted to make this quite a quick video, so I'll just cover this one. Upgraded the church, watched 4K, looked great. Made me sort of come around a bit on the movie. I never used to be overly keen, but it tells the story of this church where there's sort of like a gateway to the other side. In the hidden passageways and hallways, and all hell breaks loose. People are trapped in the church, and there's a big fire, and there's also lots of weird dreamlike demonic scenes. So there's a lot of that kind of, is it real, isn't it, kind of thing going on in the church. But good one from Mikhail Sovi. I enjoyed it a lot more this time around. I used to rate it quite low, didn't like this one at all. I prefer his other films like Stage Fright and Cemetery Man. and even The Sect, but The Church has gone up a little bit. I'll probably give it like a 3.5 now out of 5. Thought it was pretty damn good. Enjoyed watching it in 4K. Good stuff. So there's my watches, basically. That's what I've been watching on physical media. I've watched a bit more than I've shown on this video because I've been watching some streaming stuff as well. But I'll cover that on the overall monthly watch video. You know, what I do is I sort of like go on Letterboxd and record, screen record and talk about every film I've watched, so I can sort of like get into the streaming content as well, which I've been watching. But there's my physical media watches. So some good ones for the week: Texas Chainsaw Massacre, 4K, The Church, the Sleazebag, Sinful Dwarf, Tales from the Dark Side 4K, Funeral Home, and Midnight. They're my sort of physical media watches for the week. Hopefully get some more in today. That's all anyway. I'll see you on the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.